Welcome to another edition of Question and Answer with a Criminal Defense Attorney. I'm Mark Solomon, a defense attorney in Denver, Colorado, and today's question is about property and evidence. But before we get to that, don't forget to click like if you're enjoying this video and subscribe with the little bell next to it to be notified of future videos. So the question today is property and evidence. And the question that I get all the time is, the police took my things, when do I get it back? And the answer to that is to try to figure out whether the police or the prosecutors think that the held evidence, whether the held property is property or evidence. In other words, did they take your cell phone because you had it on you when you were being arrested, or did they confiscate your cell phone to get a search warrant to search it for evidence? Same thing with a car, same thing with anything. If they take your stuff, it's either going to be released to you because it's property, with an exception, or it's going to be held until the end of the case because it's evidence. In other words, they need that thing that they seized to be able to prosecute you. So in other words, if you plead guilty to something, they will usually return the property with some exceptions. And if it is something they cannot return to you, then it may be forfeited or destroyed. So let's look at that in writing. So property gets returned right away. Evidence is held until the case is over. Sometimes it is forfeited or destroyed. What does that mean? So first off, how can they take your property? The answer is, if it's on you when you're being arrested, then they're going to take it for safekeeping. They'll inventory it to make sure that you get it back. That's often a backdoor to searching, but we'll talk about that in another video. But if they take your property because you're being arrested and it's with you, they can't just leave it wherever it was when you were arrested, you know, even if it was in your home sometimes. They'll take it, seize it, evidence it, do an inventory receipt, and then you'll get it back. On the other hand, if the thing they took is something that's illegal, and there's some court cases about marijuana, if they take your marijuana, they are never giving it back, because under federal law, it's still a Schedule I substance, so they cannot give it back lest they be committing the act of trafficking in marijuana, distributing. So they don't do that. They destroy marijuana. Sometimes local statutes, like in Aurora, mandates that any seized firearms be destroyed. So they don't typically give those back. Under certain circumstances, they might be able to, but usually they will want to keep that and destroy it, and the guns will be forfeited. Same thing with any illegal drugs. Other than marijuana, they're never going to give that back. Even if it was illegally seized, they can't give back something that's illegal. Now, Denver and Aurora, I've done a number of cases involving nuisance complaints, where if you're charged with prostitution or driving under revocation or drug trafficking, and it involves either a house or a car, they will seize the thing and file the city. This is not the state. Sometimes the state does it too, but generally under the nuisance statutes, what they'll do is they'll do a nuisance action against the house or the car for the purposes of taking it, keeping it, and selling it to get the money. I don't typically do these cases anymore, but that's another way that they can hold on to your car and not give it back if they think it's being used with a crime and is against the public nuisance statute of the city where it's happening. Okay, so property gets returned, evidence gets held until the end of the case, and usually returned at the other end of it. Okay. That is the question and answer for today. If you would like your own question answered in a future video, don't forget, you can always put it in the comments below, email me, or put it on Twitter. And as always, you have a right to remain silent. If the police officers are asking you questions about what you have, where you've been, what you know, or anything, you have a right to ask for an attorney or to say, I just don't want to talk to you.